Welcome to the Coronavirus Weekly Brief. I'm David Sterman.
And I'm Melissa Salyk-Virk with New America. Here are the headlines you need to know.
According to the Associated Press, White House officials want to limit President Trump's role in the coronavirus task force briefings. The call to limit President Trump's role comes after Trump was criticized by Democrats and health experts for propagating the dangerous idea of injecting disinfectant into coronavirus patients to help them fight the pathogen.
FDA communications to the American public now echo national and global medical reports of severe side effects from taking hydroxychloroquine and chloroquine. On April 24th, the U.S. Food and Drug Administration released a drug safety communication on hydroxychloroquine and chloroquine for COVID-19 treatment, saying, quote, "The FDA is aware of reports of serious heart rhythm problems in patients with COVID-19 treated with hydroxychloroquine or chloroquine, often in combination with azithromycin and other QT prolonging medicines. Therefore, we would like to remind healthcare professionals and patients of the known risks associated with both hydroxychloroquine and chloroquine," unquote. President Trump has called hydroxychloroquine a game changer. And while hydroxychloroquine has had some anecdotal instances of success, it has serious side effects, according to the Financial Times.
In the last month, a French hydroxychloroquine study revealed cardiovascular side effects such as sudden death and electrocardiographic rhythm disorders. And data released by the U.S. Veterans Health Administration last week showed that patients taking hydroxychloroquine were no less likely to need mechanical ventilation and had higher death rates compared to those who did not take the drug. While not yet peer-reviewed, this research was funded by the University of Virginia and the National Institutes of Health. There is still no approved treatment for COVID-19.
And social distancing will be with us through the summer. On Sunday, White House Coronavirus Task Force member Dr. Deborah Birx stated on NBC's Meet the Press that, quote, "social distancing will be with us through the summer to really ensure that we protect one another," unquote. This statement is contradictory to comments Vice President Mike Pence made during a Friday radio interview with WTAM in Ohio, stating, quote, "I think, honestly, if you look at the trends today, that I think by Memorial Day weekend, we will largely have this coronavirus epidemic behind us," unquote. Birx emphasized the importance of testing in order to watch the coronavirus case curves across states. Watching the curves flatten is a strong indicator that economies can begin to reopen. Birx continued that states will have more accurate tests in the next 2 to 3 weeks.
The World Health Organization has warned governments against issuing immunity passes to allow people who show antibodies for coronavirus to return to work, says the Financial Times and others. There is, quote, "no evidence," unquote, that people who have recovered from COVID-19 are protected from a second infection, the WHO said in a scientific brief published Friday. But the WHO noted in a later clarifying tweet, "we expect that most people who are infected with COVID-19 will develop an antibody response that will provide some level of protection." The brief also said antibody tests need further validation to ensure that they do not give false positives or false negatives. Not all countries view themselves as dependent upon immunity for reopening the economy. Canadian Prime Minister Justin Trudeau said on Saturday that his plans to restart the Canadian economy do not depend on presuming people who have recovered from coronavirus developed immunity to it.
The White House is considering removing Health and Human Services Secretary Alex Azar, according to multiple reports over the weekend by Politico, The Washington Post, and The Wall Street Journal. The reports follow criticism of Azar for having contributed to the lackluster response, including a critical Wall Street Journal report based on interviews with more than 24 administration officials that we covered last week. The White House has denied any immediate plans to remove him. Trump himself took to Twitter to deny such plans, tweeting on Sunday, "the lamestream media knows this, but they are desperate to create the perception of chaos and havoc in the minds of the public. They never even called to ask."
To see our daily brief, go to the address in our show notes and follow us on Twitter at New America ISP.
Tune in next Monday for our next episode.